Hello there, guys. My name is Coach Shadong Staborn, but built for Theme Park News, and welcome to another Theme Park Newsroom update. Now, today we're going to be talking about Holiday Park in Germany, and this is all about their 2021 project. Now, obviously, for 2020 this year, they've opened their rethemed Rapids into Dino Splash, which we're going to talk a little bit about at the start of this video. And then we're going to talk about the start of construction for Wikiland, which is their brand new 2021 edition, their brand new expansion area. And we're also going to talk about some other projects that are in discussions with concepts and things like that. So before we get started, please like the video if you've loved it. Please comment down below your thoughts and opinions. Please subscribe to Coaster Channel YouTube channel for more theme park news and updates. Click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video. Please share with your friends, your family, and on social media. And make sure you keep getting your questions in using the hashtag question before or after your question. And for now, guys, let's get into this video. So, this is all about Holiday Park Germany. Now, for those of you who need a bit of a reminder as to what's happening this year, the park's Rapids ride, originally known as Donnerfluss, which originally opened in 1984, that has been rethemed this year to Dino Splash, like Plopsalander Pan's Flume Ride, Da Boom Stamp Jazz, I remember that, and Plopsaku's Slide Complex, which was an interesting name for that. So I've looked at some pictures online. You can go and check them out on the Holiday Park fan page by Coaster World Frisic Park channel Facebook page. You can go check them out. Links in the description down below for that one. But you can check out the images from there. I gave you a nice screenshot of the Dino Splash on your screen. And now I'm going to switch to another screenshot on your screen now. Fan Dabby Dozy. Now this, in terms of where it is. Now this was screenshotted from a YouTube video, from some construction. And basically, 2021 will bring to the park Wikiland, which is themed to Wiki the Viking, one of the Studio 100 characters. It'll be a copy of Plopsalander Pan's Wikiland, so it will have a brand new splash battle, and it will also be containing a brand new Zamperla Disco coaster. So with a Zamperla Disco and a splash battle, it'll be located beside the park's existing Wiki-themed log flume, and it'll also be near Expedition G-Force itself. So I don't think that means a retheme for Expedition G-Force. It'll just be, you know, involved around about that area. Now, already on your screen, you can see a construction site image from, you know, on site. And basically, it shows the map of how this is going to look. So you can see the splash battle, and you can see it comes right to the one of the edges of the disco coaster. And can I just say, by the way, doesn't that disco coaster look absolutely wonderful? Doesn't it look wonderful? You know, you got the black themed car, and you got the grassy roots. It's like you're traveling in a longboat and you're sort of, you know, riding along the grass like it's been filled with water or something. But it's like you're traveling across the water, like over the water on something. And then you've got the actual water battle and the splash battle. And as well as the rides, can I just say the theming of the buildings looked fantastic. So in terms of construction, the cranes are on site, supports are being built. The whole site's been cleared and it's all under development, ready to be, you know, construction's already underway on this, so, you know, this is a big project. And also, just to give you a quick mention of another project, plans presented a few years back for a water park similar to Plopsa Aquis has either fell through or has been put on hold for the foreseeable future. But last year, the park did also announce they're planning to add an 80-room hotel, which is featuring a pool for guests. That is expected around 2023, 2024. You can see some construction images on your screen already. So, what are my thoughts on this development? So, what I will say about this is theming level is completely off the scale. Now, obviously, this video is all about Wikiland. I'm going to focus on Wikiland specifically in this video. But what I am going to do, before I get started with Wikiland, I'm going to say straight away, quickly, the Dino Splash re-theme looks incredible. And also the concept art, which I showed you at the end of that little showreel of images, from the brand new Holiday Park Hotel concept for 2023/2024, that looks really good as well. I mean, you know, one of those concepts was already released. on a video on the channel that we did on this. But we also showed a different concept artwork as well, which was new to the channel and new to this update. So, you know, again, very, very nice to see some concepts still coming out from that new hotel project, and hopefully that will get built for 2023 or 2024, depending how they want to, you know, invest in this hotel. But now let's focus on the main part of this video, and that is, of course, Wikiland, themed to Wiki the Viking at Holiday Park for 2021. So, obviously, people are going to say, it's a clone of the one at Popsland Nippon, even though that's good, you know, I'd like to do something original. I don't mind that, to be fair. I don't mind that it's an exact replica of Popsland Nippon, because, of course, they're in Belgium. Holiday Park's in, you know, Germany. So, I think that it's nice to have a replica of the area from Belgium in Germany, because it gives the German theme park goers that can't really do long-distance traveling to Belgium a chance to experience something more local to them. And also, to be fair, I don't mind it being a replica, because the actual Popsland Nippon version looks amazing, so it's good to get us, you know, the same kind of beauty and landscaping and, you know, exceptional theming into Germany. So I like how they're doing a replica. I would have liked an original Wikiland, but I don't mind them doing a replica of Popsland Nippon, because that one is brilliant. So Holiday Park's getting a brilliant investment in 2021. You know, the Dinosplash, you know, retheme in 2020 this year was looking fantastic, and the Popsland and the Holiday Park hotel concept for 2023-2024, they look good as well. But this Wikiland looks like a fantastic investment. Hopefully Holiday Park invests in a new coaster in the future. I've got my own thoughts aside from that. And I really want them to invest in a coaster in the future. But in terms of an overall themed project, I think this is going to bite the biscuit. I think this is going to be a fantastic addition to the park. And I think that having that Splash Battle is a very good fit for the park. It's a nice family attraction. It's a very nice, fun attraction for all family. And the Zamperla Disco Coaster, that's a great investment for the thrill seekers of the park. It's great to get those thrilling sensations. I've done a Zamperla Disco Coaster. I did the Avatar Airbender at Blackpool Pleasure Beach. And, you know, even though that wasn't the wasn't the one with the airtime hill, you know, I think that that was still a great investment for the park. I think that was still a great coaster for the park, or attraction, should we say. And it felt like a good attraction. It felt very smooth. It felt, from my own experience on Avatar Airbender, it felt very, you know, it felt very smooth. It felt very, you know, fluent in the movement while the car was spinning around and going around the curves now and then. And I think from my own experience, I think that a Zamperla Disco Coaster or Disco Attraction is a great ride for the park. And I think it's a great attraction for the theme park. So I think they've, you know, chosen their investments very, very carefully. And they've chosen them very, very well. So like the rest of the Plopsa parks, I think Holiday Park's got a very exciting future with Dinosplash this year, Wikiland coming next year, and of course the new hotel in 2023 or 2024. Like I said, I want to see a brand new coaster at this park in a few years' time, but for now at least, I think this is going to be a great investment, and I think all the investments are fantastic with this park. So, you know, there we go. So that is my thoughts on this. Like we said, a disco coaster and a Splash Battle going to be located next to their wiki-themed log flume, which I suggest will be part of the land as well, even though it's not on the concept map on the construction site fence. You know, I think the log flume will be incorporated into the area, and of course it's located near Expedition G-Force as well. That won't be part of the area, in my opinion. I definitely don't think that'll be part of the area, but what I will say is that it's nice to have a coaster and then a nicely themed area right next to it. So there we go. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this video. My name is Coast Shell. Please like, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell for more videos. And for now, guys, keep on the coast life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have an awesome day.